Okay, very good. So this on the slides, I think goes from about slide four to the very tail end of slide five here. So what I thought I would do is share my screen out and talk to you about how some of this stuff looks when you do a good job of actually formatting a Word document. So I'm going to bring up my Word document and bring it up to this screen and show you how it starts to look on the outline. So first, remember, we're doing the body right now. So I asked for folks to do the word body bolded and then centered. And then I asked for students to still keep it bolded, but go to the left margin once they start to do their main points. So main point one, I want some kind of simple label. Main point two, I want some kind of simple label. And then main point three, I want some kind of simple label. By the way, sometimes Microsoft Word will automatically start formatting things and like indenting them. If you have that little like lightning bolt that comes open and you select opt into stop automatically creating numbered lists or something, you'll have more control of where things go. So underneath your main point ones, which these are all Roman numerals, by the way, one, two, and three, I don't want them as one simple label, two simple label. I want them as Roman numeral one, two, and three on your outlines. So once you're there, you can do your A, your B, and if you want to, you can do a C. Remember, I told you in the previous little mini lecture that I wanted three main points. Usually, you do three main points and three subpoints and three subpoints underneath each one. But that is not something that has to happen. There are some times where maybe even on the first one that you'll do three, but on the second one, you'll decide that you only want to have an A and a B. And on the third one, you'll go back maybe to have an A, B, and a C. You really have complete control, or you might just say, well, I only want to use an A and a B underneath each one of these things. And how will you know? Well, it's one, have you covered what you wanted to cover? And two, do you have the kind of balance that you want? And three, are you struggling with time at all? This is only a 6 to 8 minute speech. And to just let you know, the usual thing that students struggle with is going over on time, not going under. You find you're going over, well, then try to find the sub point that you think is the least interesting underneath each main point and start to whittle that away. So some students will also choose to think in terms of sub points and put Arabic numerals ones and twos under those. Some won't. It just depends on what your personality is, to be honest. Some of you, when you're putting away your homework, you put your homework for spring semester 2021, and then you have your anthropology class, your physics class, and your philosophy class. And then in your anthropology class, you have things like another folder for written work, discussion boards, journals, research, and you do folders for each one of those. Other students don't do that at all. They have documents, and then underneath that, they have something like College of Western Idaho, and they just put all their documents underneath there. So we all think and organize just a little differently. So it depends on how you're built, on whether or not you're going to want to be doing lots of sub points or not. But I do demand that you at least organize to the level of main point and sub point. So that's really the way that I want this to look. And I haven't got to exactly what transitions are yet, but the transitions I want to be in parentheses to the left margin and bolded again. So usually what you do is you look back and then look forward. And so even little keywords like this could be enough for you to remember what the heck you're going to do. But you might want to say, let's say the simple label here is 70s. And then the simple label here is 80s. Then what you would just do is on your transition, just go 70s and 80s. And that would remind you of what you're going to do in your transitions. And again, more of that is to come in the next lecture. So that's the way that I want you to be using your Roman numerals, your capital letter A's, not small A's. So I don't want little A's and little B's. I want big A's and big B's. And why, somebody might be asking why. Well, that's because some people might organize as sub points. And if they do that, they would do little A's and little B's underneath there. That's the usual way of organizing. Roman numerals, capitals, Arabic numerals, little letters. Okay, I hope that helps you there with what I'm expecting on how you format your outlines. And I have a reason for this, because I know some of you might be bothered by what's wrong with this guy. Why is he so picky about what he wants? I've been doing this a long time, and I want your indentation and your letters and things to be there so that while you're orating, if you have a memory blast, your outline, because you'll have the outline with you as you're orating, will be there to rescue you during those memory blasts. So it's just evidenced over the course of time that if a student has a really strong outline, a well-organized and well-formatted outline, it rescues them while they're orating and helps them to deliver much better. Okay, I hope that helps.